Hello, I'm Gary Johnson, the University of Minnesota Department of Forest Resources, and what we're going to show you now is something that you don't have to do to every single tree, but if you do purchase bare root trees in the spring and plant them in landscapes, you probably have noticed this in the past. Some of them will leaf out just beautifully, almost, you know, by the time you get them in the ground and the sun comes out, they're leafing out. Others can take weeks, I mean literally weeks, before they'll finally break bud. Those trees require what we call a sweating process. Most trees that you buy bare rooted in the spring were actually harvested the previous autumn. Then they're put in cold storage for weeks or sometimes months, and then pulled out in the spring, and they start shipping to different parts of the country. The longer a tree is in cold storage like that, the longer it takes for them to come out of that period of rest. And for some trees, like I say, it's a matter of just a couple days. Other trees, it can be weeks. The nut trees, and for instance, the oak trees, are kind of notorious for that. When you get them, if you don't sweat them, it's not unusual for them to take 3, 4, 5 weeks before they leaf out. And here's the problem with that. Let's say you got those in May, early May, and you plant them and they don't fully leaf out until mid-June or the third week of June. This is a relatively short growing season in the upper Midwest, and they've already lost 4 or 5 weeks of potential photosynthesis and energy storage. So it kind of puts them at a bit of a disadvantage going into the winter. If you sweat them, most of the time, even with oaks, probably the longest I've ever had to sweat an oak is maybe 10 days. Most of the time when you sweat trees, it's going to be somewhere between three days and, you know, 9 or 10 days. So we have a tree here. It was pulled out of the cooler recently. It has not broken bud yet. Buds haven't even started to swell. It is a northern pin oak. It is bare rooted, so we're going to sweat it. First thing about sweating is you need to have your blanket. You're going to put this thing into a tree burrito, and you need to have that burrito in contact with the ground. The earth is constantly radiating warmth, and if you put this up on a bench or hang it up in the garage or something, you're defeating the purpose of sweating. So it's got to be in contact with the ground to catch that heat. The next thing you need is moisture. And you only really need the moisture around the root system. And you can use Excelsior, you can use wet blankets, you can use wet straw. I like to use wet burlap. It's easy to use, and when you're done, it's easy to dry out and store. So just get the burlap good and wet, put it over the root system. Now the next thing you do is make sure that the branches, the buds up there, are accessible, because you're going to be checking those every 2, 3, 4 days. So now we're going to kind of seal it off, and I'm just using a plain old tarp here, which works just fine. Tuck this under because we want to retain that humidity. Close it off up here. If you're in a windy area, you can tie this up a little bit with twine. Except don't tie up the end, because every 2 or 3 days you're going to come back out here, you're going to pull this back, and you're going to look at the buds. And as soon as you see the buds swelling, you can see those bud scales start to pull apart, you're done. It's ready to be planted. It's gone through the sweating process. And when you check, just every once in a while, check that burlap. Yep, good and moist. If it's starting to dry out, add some more moisture to it. And then the final thing, notice that we're in a shady area. Do not do this in a sunny spot. You will parboil, you're going to kill the tree. That's what will happen. So put it on the north side or the east side of a barn or a garage. We're putting it in this pleached area here. Under the shade of trees, we have a huge crabapple that we sweat a lot of our trees under, that crabapple. So anything that provides some shade, that's kind of the final step. If you'd like to learn more about sweating plants, go to trees.umn.edu, and you'll find a publication. Actually, it's a fact sheet in there. Is planting starts with a good sweat, and that takes you through this whole thing step by step. It also lists all the trees that do require sweating to break bud and leaf out normally. So that's it for sweating, folks. Thanks for joining us.